Hello students, today we are going to discuss one problem based on module 5 heat exchanger chapter. Here one problem is given. A control flow heat exchanger is employed to cool 0.55 kg per second and specific heat 2.45 kilojoules per kg degree centigrade of oil from 115 degree centigrade to 40 degree centigrade by the use of water. The inlet and outlet temperatures of cooling water are 15 degree centigrade and 75 degree centigrade respectively. The overall heat transfer coefficient is expected to be 1450 watt per meter square degree centigrade. Using NTU method, calculate the following. First one, the mass flow rate of the water, and second one is effectiveness of heat exchanger and the surface area required. So this is almost a previous kind of problem only, but you have to use by NTU method. So using that concept, we have to solve this problem. Okay. First of all, before solving this problem, we have to understand what kind of heat exchanger it is. But in the problem, it is given directly that is the control flow type of heat exchanger. So immediately we have to draw the sketch for the graph which is shown temperature versus air length. We can show this control flow heat exchanger. Here the hot fluid and cold fluid. It is control flow type of heat exchanger. So here the temperatures we have mentioned. So along with this we can write the given data. So this is necessary for before solving the problem. So if you sketch this diagram and data, so easy to understand to solve further. Okay, so it may out of 8 marks or 10 marks you will get 1 or 2 marks for this also. Okay, next you have to write given data. Mass of the oil, that is hot fluid, that is 0.55 kg per second. And specific heat is given 2.45 kilojoules per kg degree centigrade, and temperatures is given TH1 and TH2 are 115 and 40 degree centigrade respectively. And similarly for the cold side, temperature C1 and C2 are 15 degree centigrade and 75 degree centigrade, and overall heat transfer coefficient is given, that is 1450 watt per meter square degree centigrade. Okay, next how we can solve this further problem. Okay, the mass flow rate of the water, that is mc or m water, that is mass flow rate of the water, can be flowed by using the overall heat transfer energy balance, that is mh cph th1 minus th2 is equal to mc cpc tc2 minus tc1. This is based on the energy balance equation. So substitute all the necessary given data in this equation from the problem. So unknown is mc, so that we are find it out. So it becomes 0.55 into 2.45 into 115 minus 40 is equal to mc into 4.8. This is a specific of the water, normal temperature, and 75 minus 15 degree centigrade. That is, you will unknown is mc, that mc equals to 0.4 kg per second. This is the mass of the mass flow rate of the water. Next, the effectiveness of heat exchanger. Okay, this we can calculate by using thermal capacity of the cold stream, means cold water. We know that the thermal capacity of the hot fluid. So thermal capacity can be calculated by using mass flow rate of the cold water and mass specific heat of the cold water. Both you have to multiply, you will get the thermal capacity. That is Cc is equal to Mc into Cpc. Mc is 0.4 already we have calculated, and the specific heat of the water is 4.18. The thermal capacity is 1.672 kilowatts. Okay, 1.672 kilowatts. So these are the how you got the kilowatt. This is the unit conversion. Mass flow rate unit is kg per second, and specific heat unit is kilojoules per kg degree centigrade. Okay, So this is how you can calculate. Next, thermal capacity of the hot steam, that is oil, that is also you can calculate. There is 1.347 kilowatts. You got it. Okay. Next, here from this given after finding this thermal capacity, the thermal capacity is cold is greater than hot. Hence, the effectiveness of the heat exchanger is given by the actual heat transfer divided by maximum heat transfer. This general expression already you know, that previous problem also we have solved. That is Q actual divided by Q maximum. Q actual is TH1 minus TH2 divided by TH1 minus TC1. So this is the formula and substitute, and you will get the effectiveness. That is 150 minus 40 divided by 150 minus 15. That is 0.75. Okay, 0.75 will get the answer. 0.75. Okay, next, what we have to find out? Next, we have to find out the surface area required. Surface area required means here C minimum, that is C H is equal to 1.347 kilowatt, and C maximum, thermal capacity maximum, is 1.67. Here the thermal CC is maximum, that is why 1.672 kilowatts. By taking this ratio, C minimum divided by C max is equal to R. Okay, 1.347 divided by 1.67 is equal to 0.806. Is the 0.806 is the R value for counterflow heat exchanger. Okay, from data handbook you know this equation. Okay, you have to use the data handbook for the solving this problem. So open, this is the data handbook. So for the heat transfer problem, so from the page number 8 heat exchangers, okay, there are regenerative and storage transmitting, and you have to open that one, 152. Okay, in this 152 here we have an equation. Here there are equation page number 152 and 153, just open from heat transfer data handbook by Kodandaraman. Author is Kodandaraman, author, this author. From this author you can open page number 152. Here in 152 there are given some values. Okay, in this we have to choose for the counter flow. We have to use this equation, counter flow. This problem is based on counter flow. Counter flow, epsilon is equal to 1 minus exponential of minus n into 1 minus c divided by 1 minus c into exponential of minus n into 1 minus c, where c is nothing but c minimum divided by c max, where n is NTU, that is UA divided by c minimum. Okay. This we have to keep it in mind. So if the problem is a counter flow, you have to use this formula. Okay. Based on that, I have used that formula, page number 53. Okay, page number 53, we got this equation for counter flow. Okay, for counter flow, epsilon is equal to minus exponential of minus NTU, in bracket 1 minus R. R is nothing but C minimum divided by C max. Okay. Substitute all the values. Epsilon minus 1 into epsilon R minus 1 exponential of minus NTU of 1 minus R. Okay. So substitute all these values in the above equation. So you will get value, unknown value, that is unknown value is NTU that we are going to calculate. Okay, so this here you will get the solution by applying logarithmic. So you will get NTU is equal to 2.635. Okay. Next, this the value of NTU is also obtained from another equation, Data Handbook. R is equal to C minimum by C max or epsilon, that is NTU is equal to UA divided by C minimum. I already told this equation is shown in the Data Handbook. So once we got NTU value, we can calculate it area. So this also we can calculate it area, you can get 2.197 meter square. This is the desired answer. So I hope you students, everybody, you understand this problem. So how to use the Data Handbook for getting this NTU value as well as that R value. Okay, so this kind of problem also may ask in university examination. Thank you.